This is a computer power supply unit or PSU, and today I'm going to show you how to connect it to your car audio amplifier. Absolutely no soldering is required for this method, so let's get started. I love using these power supply units for my car audio setup at home because they are cheap, readily available, and relatively safe. And just because I said relatively safe does not mean that you don't need to protect yourself. First of all, always use a 3-pin cable. This other pin should be connected to this chassis. A beep means it's connected. The other pin to the chassis, and it's connected. It's very important because this is exposed metal. Number two, let's learn about all the voltages. Now, car audio, including head units, amplifiers, and equalizers, uses 12 volts. And that's what the power supply unit provides using all the yellow cables. All the yellow cables are 12 volts. All the red cables are 5 volts. All the orange cables are 3.3 volts. And finally, all the black cables are ground. The most important to know, yellow for 12 volts, orange for 3.3, red for 5, and black for ground. Although we just need the yellow and the black cable. I will snip these two cables from here. I will combine these two yellow cables and connect them to the positive side of my amplifier. And the two black cables for my ground. After this, we need to figure out how to turn on the power supply unit. To turn on the power supply unit, we need a short piece of wire, and we need to connect the green wire to any black wire. The green wire is usually the fourth cable. If you count here, 1, 2, 3, 4. I need to connect that green wire to any black wire. And now when I plug it in, the computer power supply unit should turn on. And you will know it's turned on because the fan will start rotating. If I shut it off, you will see the fan stop rotating. It's not rotating. If I turn it on, it should start rotating. But we need a much better method to see if this power supply unit is on. And that's why we need a small LED. Like this one. That's why I also taught you about the orange cable. The orange cable is 3.3 volts, and you need just any simple LED to connect it between the orange and black. That's 3.3 volts. If you buy a brand new LED, you will see one short leg, that is the negative, and one long leg, that is the positive. If you just removed it from an old circuit and you don't know which one is which, that flat side on the LED, that is what you connect to the negative. All computer power supply unit connectors are universal. Every single color will match with each other. Now, instead of just having this looped wire, what I do instead is I just use a switch between the green and the black. The third one is the black, fourth one is the green. Now, if I turn on the switch, you can see the light is turning on, meaning the power supply unit is on. Now, you notice that the amplifier is not on because we don't have that light. And for that, we need a short jumper cable like this one. And before I connect it, I just need to turn off the PSU. You connect this short jumper cable between the remote and the power. That's the positive connected to the yellow cable, the negative connected to the black cable, and a short jumper wire between the remote and the positive. Now, if I turn on this switch, this amplifier should turn on. There you have it. It's that simple to connect a computer power supply unit to your car audio amplifier. This is a very simple method that you can achieve right at home. You don't need a lot of tools, you just need something to cut the cables and a screwdriver. If all these cables hanging everywhere are too ugly for you, then you can actually remove all these cables and connect them inside the power supply unit like I've done here. I did this video quite a long time ago, and in that video I have an LED light as well as a switch. You don't necessarily have to use the switch that I've used, you can use any other switch. And in this PSU, I connected these cables that came with the amplifier inside the power supply unit. Now to do that, you need some level of electronics expertise. If you don't have that, please take your PSU to any qualified and trained technician and he'll do that for you. I have that video in the video's description below, so you can watch that right after you watch this video. Something else that I did with this PSU is I connected this USB cable to the 5-volt line for charging my power banks and even my phone. I connected the remote cable, the orange cable, inside the PSU to the positive line. So these two cables are connected to each other inside the power supply unit. Before I end the video, I just want to point something out. These cables are too thin, so this will work for just mid-range and a subwoofer at moderate volumes. So you need to connect every single yellow cable you see on the PSU. Make sure they are exactly the same length and connect them to the positive. If you're going to use 4 yellow cables, also use 4 black cables. That said, this PSU is powerful, but not that powerful. This one provides 13 amperes at 12 volts. This other one provided 18 amperes at 12 volts. Now these two PSUs are enough for 2 mid-range and 1 subwoofer at moderate volumes. If you're the type of person to crank up your volume too high, then you need a computer server power supply unit. Some of them even provide 100 amperes. This is just entry level stuff. And another reason I love these PSUs is that if you draw too much current, they just shut themselves down. They have internal protections to protect themselves and the CPUs they were originally connected to. So that's it. My name is Dominic. I hope you learned something new today. Let's meet in the next video. Please check the video description for the relevant videos relating to this video, including how I made this PSU unit. That's it. Thank you for watching and goodbye.